The development of the de Havilland 112 Venom began in 1948, as a proposed development of the Vampire FB-8. The British Air Ministry issued a specification for a fast maneuverable and capable fighter bomber, to replace the RAF's existing Vampires. It was planned as an interim fighter bomber, that would serve while more capable aircraft were being developed. The Venom had a twin boom design, and looked quite similar to the Vampire, but it was a completely new design. It had a more powerful engine, the de Havilland Ghost 103, and the wing had a leading edge sweepback of 17.6 degrees. It could also carry wingtip tanks, that would not negatively impact the aircraft's overall maneuvering capability. On September 2, 1949, the first Venom prototype performed its maiden flight. During the tests, the prototype proved capable enough to beat several contemporary fighters during mock dogfights, although there were some areas that needed improvement. A second prototype soon joined the testing. The first production model, the Venom FB-1, entered service in the RAF in 1952. An improved night fighter version was also developed, the Venom NF-2. The fuselage was redesigned to fit a two-man crew, and a radar in the extended nose. The NF-2 entered RAF service in late 1953. Initially it was involved in a number of accidents, which led to alterations of the flight control surfaces, as well as the adoption of jettisonable clear canopies. The altered aircraft were redesignated NF-2A. The NF-2 was soon followed by the NF-3, which had been further improved. The improvements included power-actuated ailerons and an improved radar. The NF-3 entered RAF service in June 1955. The last version of the Venom to enter RAF service was the single-seat FB-4. It entered service in 1955, and was the first Venom to be fitted with an ejector seat. It also had hydraulically powered ailerons, and redesigned tail surfaces. The Venom was designed as a fighter bomber, but it also served as an interceptor. The performance of the Venom was significantly improved over the Vampire, although its limited top speed was a weakness. The first squadrons to convert from the Vampire to the Venom were overseas squadrons. This included squadrons in Germany, Cyprus, the Middle East, Africa, and Asia. RAF Venom saw action during the Malayan Emergency from the mid-1950s, where it conducted more than 300 strikes against communist guerrillas. The aircraft type also saw combat service in the 1956 Suez Crisis, where it attacked various military installations. One Venom was lost. From 1956, Venoms were also involved in the Aden Emergency, and was used in attacks against terrorists and rebel tribesmen in Aden and Oman. In 1957, Venoms saw extensive action in the Jebel Akhdar War in Oman, making numerous raids targeting insurgents, mountaintop villages, water channels and crops. Several other countries used the Venom, including Switzerland, Sweden, Italy, Iraq, and New Zealand. Switzerland produced their own versions of the Venom under license, including a reconnaissance version that had automated cameras installed in the forward section. In Sweden, the Venom was used as the principal night fighter of the Swedish Air Force from 1955. Venoms were retired from RAF service in 1962, but in Switzerland they served until late 1983. A total of 1,431 Venoms were produced.